For the fourth year student, I hope you are getting some benefit from our review lecture. Last class, I told about hemoglobinopathies. Today, I will told about thalassemia. At first, we go for definition. The thalassemia, which is characterized by reduced rate of production of normal hemoglobin due to absence or decreased synthesis of one or more types of globulin peptides, say. Classification of thalassemia. There are two main groups of thalassemia affecting the synthesis of alphacin, which is called alpha thalassemia. The other affecting the synthesis of beta chain called beta thalassemia. In case of alpha thalassemia, we know in all of the hemoglobin A, F, and A2, there is alpha chain. So, in case of alpha thalassemia, all levels will be equally reduced. Excess beta and gamma chain aggregates to form hemoglobin H, that is beta 4, hemoglobin burst, that is gamma 4. In beta thalassemia, hemoglobin A is reduced, hemoglobin F is increased, hemoglobin A2 is increased. Because there is reduced beta chain, which leads to the increased production of gamma and delta chain. Lack of beta chain leads to the accumulation of alpha chain in red cell and cause premature destruction of the red blood cells in the bone marrow, and there is ineffective erythropoiesis. Both alpha thalassemia and beta thalassemia exist in heterozygous and homozygous states. Now we'll go through about beta thalassemia because this is the most common in our population. And for your exam purpose, beta thalassemia is the most important. Beta thalassemia occurs in two forms, beta thalassemia major, that is homozygous state. There is total suppression of beta chain synthesis. Beta thalassemia minor or trait, that is heterozygous states, there is less suppression of beta chain. The beta thalassemia related syndrome, that is electrophoretic phenotype. There is disorder hemoglobin A, hemoglobin A2, hemoglobin F. In case of beta thalassemia minor, hemoglobin A 90 to 95%, we know it is more than 97%. Hemoglobin A2 3.5 to 7%, we know this is 1.5 to 3.5%. Hemoglobin F, in case of adult, there is no hemoglobin F, but in case of beta thalassemia minor, there will be hemoglobin F 1 to 5%. Delta beta thalassemia did not to understand, but we should understand about the beta thalassemia major. That is very important for us. Beta thalassemia plus and beta thalassemia G. Beta thalassemia plus, when hemoglobin A is 10 to 90%. Hemoglobin A to 1.5 to 4%. And hemoglobin F will be 10 to 90%. Beta thalassemia, in case of beta thalassemia 0, that is hemoglobin A is 0%. Whereas hemoglobin A to 1.5% to 4%, and hemoglobin F is more than 90%. So in case of beta thalassemia plus, there is some form of hemoglobin A present, but in case of beta thalassemia 0, there is no hemoglobin A. Beta thalassemia major we have to know about the beta thalassemia major in details, because in detailed examination and there is also viva questions regarding beta thalassemia major. Clinical features of beta thalassemia major: it is usually occurs in children. The child is growth retarded and fail to thrive, anorexia, diarrhea, loss of body fat, and recurrent fever. Anemia different degree, splenomegaly, hepatomegaly, and mild jaundice. There is skeletal changes, susceptible to infections, pericarditis, and due to iron deposition. Organ dysfunction, pancreatic hemosiderosis, cardiac hemosiderosis. Because when their patient came with beta thalassemia major, they are getting multiple blood transfusion due to very low hemoglobin level. So there is iron deposition occurs. This is the beta thalassemia major patient. Blood pictures resemble that of severe iron deficiency. There is hemoglobin 6 to 9 gram per deciliter, red cell indices. There is MCV, MCS, MCHC, all are reduced, like iron deficiency. Because this is one of the hypochromic microcytic anemia. We know there is four causes of hypochromic microcytic anemia. Number one is iron deficiency anemia. Number two is thalassemia, then sideroblastic anemia, and anemia of chronic disease. In case of peripheral blood film, we see the features of red blood cell destruction. That is, there is hypochromic microcytic and anisocoagulocytosis, occasional spherocytes, polychromatic macrocytes, cystocytes, that is fragmented red blood cells are present, target cell and normoblast, that is nucleate and RBC occasion present. WBC count, total count is increased with mild shift to the left. Platelet normal or reduced by an hypersplenism, because there is splenic sequestration. This is the peripheral blood film of thalassemia, which can see here that there is nucleated RBC, there is lymphocyte, there is hypochromasia, and there is fragmented red blood cells, there is target cells, you can see. You can see there is hypochromic microcytic features, and there is fragmented red blood cells somewhere, and there is nucleated RBC. This is also a hyper view of beta thalassemia blood film. This is the nucleated RBC. This is the target cells, and this is the polychromatic cells, some form of polychromatic cells. And there is fragmented red blood cells. Other tests: reticulocyte count is usually increased, hemoglobin electrophoresis, hemoglobin A reduced or absent, hemoglobin A2 increased, hemoglobin F appear or markedly increased. Osmotic fragility test, resistance to hemolysis. X-ray scale, lateral X-ray. Lateral skull radiograph widening of the calvarium is present, producing a hair on and appearance. Well, there is an X-ray skull, lateral skull radiograph. If we take, there is widening of the calvarium, which appears as hair on and appearance. This is the hair on and appearance of the skull. This is the hair on and appearance. This is the beta thalassemia major bone changes. This is the patient and this is her X-ray skull. Diagnosis of thalassemia. This is very, very important. At first, we have to take clinical feature and family history. Because this is the genetic disease, we can take that family history. Routine hematological test, that is hemoglobin, PCB, absolute value, reticulocyte, and peripheral blood film examination. Iron profile, serum iron, total iron binding capacity, ferritin, and percentages, all are usually normal. But we know these values are usually reduced in iron deficiency anemia, especially iron, ferritin, and percentage of saturation, as TIBC is increased. Biochemical test, serum bilirubin, other biochemical tests, there is serum bilirubin marginally increased. Demonstrate hemoglobin A inclusion, hemoglobin electrophoresis, and X-ray scan. Global change synthesis rate studies, alkali denaturation and acid elution test, and gene analysis. Last of all, we do as this is the genetic disorder, so we have to do gene analysis. Today lecture is up to this thalassemia. Next lecture will be on pancytopenia. I hope I will take this lecture on Monday. Stay home and remain well. Thank you all.